Need something?
You infiltrated the position, eliminated the target, and made it look like an accident. Impressive. I'd say you earned your bonus on that one.
It's all thanks to a special technique I developed. I call it the razor-winged butterfly. I'd teach it to you, but then I'd have to kill you. You reek of death, my friend.
Need something? Until next time, brother.
So many contracts. I'll teach you how to use it effectively and keep you quick on your feet.
The shadow scales are all but forgotten.
And try not to get yourself killed.
Ancient tradition from another time.
Took your sweet time dealing with Cicero, eh? Now let's get down to business. Astrid told you about the gourmet, I hope. Quite so. But first, you'll need to learn who he is. Assuming, of course, that the gourmet actually is a he. Could be a woman, for all we know. You know, maybe I was wrong about you after all. Anyone who's smart enough to shut up and listen can't be all bad. In my, investigations, I came upon this. It's a copy of the Gourmet's cookbook, but not just any copy. It's signed, you see. Seems to be a message from the Gourmet to one Anton Varan. I've tracked Varan to the keep in Markarth. It would seem he's the cook. I believe so. Therefore, you are to obtain that information from Varan, who the gourmet really is and where he can be found. Oh, and when you're done with Varan, kill him. Loose ends and all that. Next, you'll have to... Are you still paying attention? As I was saying, you'll need to kill the gourmet, of course. But what's more, you'll need to get his writ of passage so you could take his place. Oh, and if you can, hide his body. The longer it takes for anyone else to determine his real identity, the better. Now off with you. Nobody knows his true identity. Well, nobody except Gaius Morrow, and you've already taken care of him. Well, I do know the gourmet was classically trained in traditional Breton cuisine in High Rock. So, that's where he must have met Anton Varan. In any event, our anonymous chef shares a passion for food with all of Tamriel. And that anonymity will prove the Emperor's undoing. Uncommon Taste. It was published a few years ago and became a sensation throughout the Empire almost overnight. The recipes were hailed as both practical and decadent. I made a few of the gourmet's dishes myself, actually. His roast mutton with rigardberry sauce is to die for. But his chocolate pâté gives me the runs. Yes, Gaius Morrow, on orders from his father, arranged for the gourmet to come to Skyrim months ago to serve as the Emperor's personal chef. But the Emperor canceled his journey at the last minute. Morrow was smart. Kept the gourmet around, in case things changed. And so, the gourmet has remained in seclusion, somewhere in Skyrim, on indefinite hold. Probably feels like a prisoner. But you'll fix that. Remember, the Markarth Keep. That's where you'll find Anton Varan. Probably cooking up all of the gourmet's recipes, passing them off as his own.
There you are. Look, I just wanted to say thanks for coming to find me back in Dawnstar. Crazy Jester finally met his match, am I right? The last thing you need is my help. Listener or not, you've proven yourself time and again. To Astrid, to the family, and to me. Until next time, brother.
Know anything about this house?
No.
Anyone seen entering or leaving? Any strange lights or unusual noises?
It's abandoned, and it's always been abandoned.
because the werewolves and vampires don't.
For the dragon to attack Kynes Grove.
Why?
Why then?
There's no place to.
I'm sure you're hot for a bunch of jump.
What are you hiding, priest?
I'm not hiding anything. It's closed for a reason.
Typical Imperial lies. First, you take away Talos. Now you're keeping us from seeing our honor dead? You and the Jarl will answer for any desecration of my ancestors' bodies.
That's enough, Thongvor. We're done.
The Silverblood family will be hurt.
Gorza is the one you should ask if you need anything.
For the 100th time, I am a Breton. I was born in High Rock, and then I came here. I am not a Reachman. Yes, yes, for the 100th time, I am a Breton. I was born in High Rock, and then I came here. I am not a Reachman. Who are you? What do you want? The Gourmet? Never! I don't know what led you here, but nothing will betray my trust. I'll take the secret of the Gourmet's identity to my grave. The Dark Brotherhood? Now, wait a minute. Let's not get hasty. I mean, surely my friend wouldn't want me to endanger my own life, right? Look, his name is Balagor Gronolob. He's an orc. The Gourmet's an orc. He's staying at the Nightgate Inn. That's all I know. Now you'll let me go, right? So, we're done?
Mind the dogs. They get anxious when they haven't had dinner. You should talk to Anton if you need anything. He's the master chef. It's been a hard day cleaning. Good honest work, I say.
Oh,
what are you doing that for?
This can't be happening.
Dominion is here, and we're watching you.
you want anything. Think I got a clean mug around here somewhere.
What do you want? You see any other inns around here? Where else would I go to drink? Sure, walk away. I wasn't talking or anything.
Ah, hello there, traveler. Come to the Night Gate for food or lodging? Some fool is opening a museum in Dawnstar. They say he's paying people to collect artifacts from that old Mythic Dawn cult. Here, take a look at this. Some of the Jarl's men came by and left this bounty letter. This old place? Huh. Been here forever. Built by my great-granda. Run by him, then all the way up the line to me. Nah, not so much. The odd traveler on the road. But mostly just old full-time. Come to drink away a lifetime of bad memories, I'd wager. Of course, there's the orc. Long-term tenant, that one. For what he pays, I could afford to shut this place down. Him? Balablob, or, Malaklob, one of them funny orc names. Talks real good, though. Not a savage at all. Said he's a writer. Don't know what kind of job that is, but it must earn him some pretty coin. He's paid up for the next few months. He mostly just hangs about. Goes down to the lake. Sometimes samples the stores of wine in the cellar. Man can do whatever he pleases, far as I care.
Anything you need, just holler. What are you doing that for?
Whatever it is, I'm sure I can't be of help. I'm just here on holiday. Yes, well, perhaps someone else in the village can assist you. Please, you're starting to frighten me.
Thank you. that an amulet of Mara? I'm surprised someone like you isn't spoken for.
Brother?
Greetings, brother.
So, the prodigal murderer returns. And the gourmet? So I gathered. It seems a certain orc has disappeared. Which means you not only killed the gourmet, but disposed of the body as well. Oh, you've got the writ of passage too, I see. Splendid. Splendid! Ah, and word has come in from Markarth that the keep's cook has met an untimely demise. You performed your duties to the letter.
I was wrong about you. I see that now. Maybe we all were. Here's your payment, and a little something else as well, from me. Consider it my way of apologizing for being so damn curmudgeonly. It's called the Night Weaver's Band. I wore this for years. I want you to have it now. It'll give your magic and sneakiness some much-needed oomph. Now you'd better get a move on and see Astrid. It's time. Time for the final stage of this grand and glorious operation.
Need something?
Don't take offense to the nicknames, Morsel. I'm a werewolf. Hard not to think of you as a snack.
It's been quite a boon, looking like my targets make the mistake of not perceiving me as a threat. Last mistake they ever make.
So it's done. You've killed the Gourmet. And now, Titus Mead II is as good as dead. Oh, yes. And I've decided you will have the honor. Look at you. So calm, so confident. I do believe you were born for this task. So let's begin. Go now to Castle Dower in Solitude. Present the Gourmet's writ of passage to the officer in charge, Commander Marrow. I'm sure you remember him. You'll gain unrestricted access to the kitchens, and then the Emperor. You're posing as a chef, so you'll be able to poison his meal rather easily. Here, take this. It's called Geron Root. All it takes is one taste, and the effects are quite immediate. The Emperor will be serving Sithis before he even knows he's dead. Once Mead has been killed, escape through the upper door and across the bridge. I've arranged for it to be unguarded once the alarm is sounded. Now go, my friend. Go and fulfill your destiny as listener. It's a rare plant, found only on the island of Stros Mackay. It can be served like any vegetable. Cut up, put in a salad, perhaps boiled in a stew. One taste will lead to nearly instant death, so don't even think about it. It took all the favors, bribes, and blackmails I could muster, but I've secured your exit out of the keep. Just follow my instructions, and the Dark Brotherhood will be back on top. All thanks to you. Listener. Kill well, and often. Need something? Need something? Need something?